Innovation. It's the heart of every successful startup, and it keeps established companies ahead of the curve. In this video, I'm going to share with you two simple techniques that you can use to create massive innovation. I'm Dr. Srikant Sola, cardiologist turned entrepreneur, and this is the Startup Clinic. Let's start by looking at three prerequisites for successful innovation. Steve Jobs is widely acclaimed as bringing the iPhone to the world, but obviously he did not do this all by himself. Collaboration is the first prerequisite for successful innovation. If we look at the lives of famous inventors or scientists, Marie Curie, Thomas Edison, they oftentimes did not succeed on the first attempt, or sometimes even on the 100th attempt. Persistence and perseverance are the second prerequisite for successful innovation. And third, let's look at one of my favorite composers, Beethoven. His classic Ninth Symphony today is still the most widely performed orchestral symphony in the world. Yet Beethoven wrote this when he was completely deaf. He was supported by the fact that he lived in 19th century Vienna, which at that time was the epicenter of Western classical music. He had access to the finest musicians and symphonies of his time, and he was supported by the nobility, the royalty of Vienna. This allowed him to work unobstructed, unhindered for days and weeks and months to create his masterpiece. A conducive environment is the third prerequisite for successful innovation. Now, let's look at the two steps that you need to follow to create massive innovation. The first is inner silence. Inner silence. This is a silence that comes from inside, and it's a tremendous power that many of us don't even realize we have. Inner silence is not merely the cessation of speech, it's a cessation of thoughts. Now, I know a lot of you are going to be saying, oh, that's way too much for me, I just can't do that. But actually, most of us do this all the time. Think about it. If you're an athlete in the zone, you're in that state of silence. A musician creating a beautiful music, or an artist crafting a beautiful masterpiece, or a mother with a small baby. All of them go into different stages or states of inner silence to create beautiful things, and you can too. Now, I'm going to give you two simple things you can do to go into inner silence. The first is meditation, and you can read about this, you can learn about this on the net. There are plenty of easy ways to meditate nowadays. My favorite meditations are the thumb meditation and the soham meditation. Another type of meditation that I really enjoy are the Buddhist mindfulness techniques, and they're really simple and easy to practice. Another way to go into really deep states of silence is to go into nature. Nature has this ability to absorb the inner noise that we're constantly creating. So next time you need to go into silence, go for a walk in the park, head out into the forest, or hike up a mountain, and you'll see that you can go into states of silence that are very beautiful. The second technique. For many of you, this is going to be new, so I really need you to pay attention to what I'm about to share with you. For this second technique, you have to know, K-N-O-W, you have to know that you already know the answer. Let me say it again. You have to know that you already know the answer. You already know what you need to find or do to make the solution work. It's a change in mindset, but it's not so much up here as it is here in the heart. It's a knowingness. It's not a belief. It's not a thought. It's just a knowingness. Why is this so important? My guru, Sri Satya Sai Baba, said that creation is designed so that wherever a problem is found, right next to it, the solution is present. Now, he did not mean that you have to physically go there to find it. What he meant was in the inner space. So when you have that inner silence, when you have that knowingness that the answer is already there, then that innovation will percolate upwards. And with collaboration, with perseverance and persistence, and with a conducive environment, you will be able to create massive innovation that will change your personal finances, your relationships, your career, your community, and hopefully, the world.